Wow, that's a lot of comments. That's a lot of comments, guys. You guys are crazy. If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up, guys? I'm Rob. Welcome to my channel. So just now, guys, I posted on my Insta story asking you guys for suggestions and ideas for my upcoming videos, and man, I was surprised. You guys sent me so many comments. So I was just going through the comments and I realized you want DIYs around superheroes, videos about calligraphy, you want me to do some cheap art supplies videos, or mobile stand, mobile covers, room decor ideas, and basically some simple and fun techniques that you can do in your free time. So first of all, thank you so much for all these ideas and suggestions. You just made my job easier. So from now on, all my DIY videos will be all your requests. And even today, I am doing a really fun and interesting technique. It's also very simple, and I'm very sure a lot of you must have already tried it, but I am going to add my twist to it. So it'll be even more interesting. And why I personally like it is because every time you do it, the result is always a surprise. So today we are doing thread art or pull string art technique. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Alright, so let's get started. So like I said, we are doing string art or pull thread art. So for that you need thread. You can see I have this thick thread here. The thicker one gives nicer patterns, so I'm using this one. Now we have to take about half a meter. There you go. I think this much is enough. And now I will cut it. So as you can see, I have like a longish piece of thread here. Why you need such a long piece is to create your patterns. When you're placing it onto the sketchbook, keep it in a particular form, like an S curve, like a snake-like form, or you can keep it in a circular form, or just like a random shape. So when you pull it, you'll get some really interesting patterns. But your thread should not be too long, because when you're trying to make patterns here, if you overlap it too much, then you won't get an interesting pattern. Instead, you will just get a blob of color. So about this much length is enough. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create three patterns on this. So I'm gonna take three pieces of thread and similar length. So you can hold one end like this and pull it and then cut it. And I'll do this one more time. So there you go. I have three pieces of thread here, approximately the same length. So now this is ready, so we can keep it aside. Now to make your patterns, you need color. So here I'm using photo inks. I'm using photo ink because it's a dilute medium and you get them in different colors. If you want, you can also take watercolors or acrylic colors, but you'll have to dilute it so that it has the ink-like consistency. It should be very watery, almost liquid-like. So inks work best. So let's take some ink in these paper cups. So here I'm just picking the colors I like, but you can pick colors according to a certain design you want to make, or just whatever you like, your favorite colors. All right, so my inks are ready. Now I'm gonna dip the thread, but this tends to get a little messy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keep some tissue aside so I can dab if there is a spill, and I'm gonna wear gloves. There you go. I have some rubber gloves on. Now let's take the thread and dip it in the ink. Okay, so now I've dipped the thread in the ink and I'm taking the excess off. If you have too much ink on the thread, then it just makes a blob, and now you can just place it. So as you can see, I'm placing the thread in this wavy kind of form, almost like a snake-like form, or these really curvy S. So like I said, you can place it in any form you like. You can make circles, you can make these wavy forms. And once you are done, all you need to do is just close the book. If you're doing it on paper, then place another sheet of paper on top, press it down, keep something heavy or flat on top of it, like that, and then apply a little bit of pressure and then pull the string. And once you're done pulling the string, then all you need to do is open the book and be surprised with the patterns you get. And there you go. As you can see, we have these really nice patterns. And like I said, the way you place the thread is how you're gonna get the shape of your pattern. So if you make it more circular, then you'll get more round patterns, because I placed it like an S curve or like a snake. So I have this nice flower-like shape. Now, if you want, you can just use this as is. You can frame it and it looks like a nice, beautiful frame or a painting with these nice patterns. Or you can use these patterns and draw small doodles around it so that this whole thing looks like one nice, whimsical fantasy art or painting. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. So let's get rid of the gloves. Now, to draw fantasy art, it's best to draw from imagination, but you can also look at references. So what I'm doing here is, in the middle pattern, this blue one, I am drawing this tiny dragon that is resting on the top. And around the dragon, I am going to draw tiny planets or things floating around. And on the orange one, I am drawing some dogs, like they are looking for this dragon, they're trying to chase the dragons. And on the other side, on the red one, I am just drawing a tiny house. Again, the shape of the house, as you can see, I'm drawing a little eerie and strange so that it adds to this whole fantasy, whimsical kind of theme. And you can keep adding more details to it, like tiny rocks or some kind of foliage or whatever you like. And there you go. I am done. I'm pretty happy with the result. And you can see that we had these really crazy patterns with the thread. And on top of that, I have done these tiny doodles, which took me no time. And with those doodles, this actually looks like a really cool painting. And now I am going to just frame it and hang it in my room. So that was my take or my twist on thread art or pull string art technique. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then please like the video, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, then please subscribe to my vlog channel, Robin the Hood. Also, you can follow me on Instagram. There are the handles. Why I'm saying Instagram? Because if you're trying it, then you can click pictures and share them with me on Instagram, and then we can have a chat. Also, we can have a chat here in the comments below. So send in more ideas or suggestions, or I don't know, let me know what you're up to. That's it, guys. That's the end of the video. I'll see you in my next one with another fun DIY. And in the end, like I always say, do good and be good. Peace.